Hello and welcome everyone. So I'm a computer scientist with a PhD in mechatronics. I clearly love technology and enjoy talking about the future and emerging technologies. Yet I am also a concerned, relatively young person who cares about the world and nature. So my research is about data-driven cyber-physical systems for integrated smart infrastructure, as Jennifer also said. And I'm mainly interested with interoperability, sustainability, and complexity related to these systems. Today, as the title suggests, I will mainly talk about a few things: data, cyber-physical systems, integration, and intelligence or smartness. Cyber-physical systems are the products of the fourth industrial revolution. They require software systems, communication technologies, sensors, actuators, embedded systems, and physical processes to work together seamlessly. And they are seen as the driving force behind digital transformation. My study aims to understand how data-driven approaches could turn the passive infrastructure assets to cyber-physical systems to enable sustainable and resilient decision making. I have been part of several research projects related to these systems, and I have implemented several different levels of digital twins for these systems. Some of these projects include integrated transport systems, autonomous vehicles and cars and drones, automated warehouses with collaborative robots, smart manufacturing applications for automotive industry, and now I am working with digital twins for smart infrastructure. After all these years, I have learned a few things related to these systems and digital twin implementations. One very important lesson that I learned is purely about the data. Many call data as the new oil. I hope that we can find a better metaphor and create a brighter future direction for data. Even though the oil-driven revolution fueled many industries and helped the world to advance, the waste of this revolution, the greenhouse gases, and the effects on climate change is the biggest problem that is threatening the future of this world. When we look at some instances, even the very mature technology providers who are leading the data-driven revolution are having difficulties to deal with the challenges around data. As a result, chatbots are turning to racist, autonomous cars are running red lights, and many are spending incredible amount of investments and time to short-term solutions. It is impossible to suggest data-driven strategies without addressing challenges related to data, such as availability, accessibility, quality, volume, and more. Therefore, the research work that I lead comments on all these challenges and proposes different ways to provide high quality, right data to the right people at the right time. We discuss different alternatives to deal with the heterogeneity of the data, to integrate different data sources while considering future changes, and ultimately suggest ways to enable better, more sustainable, more resilient, long-term decisions. This rapidly changing data-driven new world is exciting, yet it is complex. We will need to find a way to design, construct, operate, and maintain our infrastructure differently, because they will not act as passive individual structures any longer. Instead, they will be part of a network of integrated systems of systems. For example, we will have connected bridges that will talk with trains, passengers, railways, collect data not only about health monitoring, but also about weather, water, traffic, and propagate this information through interoperable digital twin platforms. They will be cyber-physical systems, and they will be data-driven. This will require them to become cloud-based service providers, for instance. They will be required to have automated decision-making abilities through data and artificial intelligence. And they will be certainly carbon aware and sustainable. Another important lesson that I have learned is about building a structural change and operationalize data. As data has its own limitations, we and our organizations have similar limitations. To be able to exist in this new world, we need to reconsider our organizational structures, including a continuous skill development programs for everyone. We need to improve our organization's digital capabilities, try new approaches, technologies, tools, and develop data and technology fluency in our organizations. We should develop better processes and well-defined data procedures, which helps us to deal with the challenges that we have mentioned earlier. And lastly, we should start to shift our mindsets. We need to design for people with people. We need to have future-oriented thinking, and we need to see interconnected systems or systems perspective. Data and cyber-physical systems are here to change the infrastructure. Let's take this opportunity to use our infrastructure efficiently and bring a sustainable and carbon-free world within reach. Thank you very much.